As we told you earlier, the earthquake triggered a tsunami that raged at high speed all day across the Pacific, prompting warnings on the west coast of the U.S. and Canada, and even as far away as Australia and New Zealand. But it was Hawaii that loomed all day as the tsunami's prime target. And tonight, officials there are saying they dodged a bullet. Early show weatherman Dave Price was on the Big Island when the tsunami came ashore. I spoke with him via Skype a short time ago. Dave, I know you went there on vacation only to find yourself on the front lines of a potential tsunami. What's been going on there all day?
Well, Russ, like a lot of people, I came out here for a break from the normal everyday stresses. People typically come to this beautiful Big Island of Hawaii explicitly for the water. But today, people have been running from it. Hundreds of people evacuated from the hotel behind me and thousands across the Hawaiian island chain. And all of this started early this morning.
Tsunami warning has been issued.
It began with an ominous voicemail left on every guest's phone. School buses were brought in to take out anyone with no way to get to a higher ground or a safer place. And by 11:30 in the morning, the resort was a ghost town.
If you look at resorts like this, they're just steps away from the water's edge. And a 12-foot wall of water can not only bring property damage, it can bring death.
One of the hotel staff members helping in the evacuation has lived through this horror before. He was in Phuket, Thailand for the Christmas Indonesian tsunami of 2004.
It's not a game. I've seen three SUVs stacked on two-story buildings in Phuket Island, and it's like literally bombs going off all across the coast. That's how bad.
What's remarkable is that watching the water today has been like a spectator sport. Everyone's eyes glued right towards the shoreline. Waiting, watching, and worrying. Russ?
Okay, Dave Price on Hawaii's Big Island. Thank you so much, and take care.
You bet.